Hi, I'm Mark Needham with StarTree, and in this video we're going to learn about the time boundary when working with Apache Pinot hybrid tables. Now a hybrid table is one that has an offline table and a real-time one with the same name. So the real-time table is for ingesting data from a streaming data platform, and then the offline one is for batch ingesting historical data. Let's have a look at an events hybrid table in the Pinot UI. So you can see here if we've got some data coming in, and if we refresh the table, we can see the data is still coming in and we're seeing more records returned by this query. Now let's write a query to check which data is in the offline table and which one's in the real-time table. And one way we can do this is to count the number of records by their segment name. Now a segment is Pinot's unit of storage, and it contains a subset of rows with all the columns for a table. And so if we run this query using the $segmentName variable, we can see that there are a few different segments, including one that contains the word offline that has 99,999 records. And so that one, yeah, the name kind of indicates that is a segment in the offline table. Now we can also write a query to count the number of records in just the offline table by putting the underscore offline at the end of the table name. So using that as a suffix. And that query actually says there are 100,000 records. So what's going on? We've lost one record. One time it was 99,999, and now it's saying it's 100,000. So let's see if we can figure that out. So to understand what's happened here, we need to know how Pinot works out which records to get from an offline table and which ones from the real-time table when it's doing queries that have both, like, that can get data from two places. Now it does this by computing a time boundary, which is the maximum end time of the offline segments minus the ingestion frequency. Now the before boundary will then be taking data from the offline table, and then after the boundary will be taking data from the real-time table. Now as I say, there are two components here. So let's first check what's the maximum time of records in the offline table. So we can write a query to work that out, and you can see it's 6:41 p.m. on the 9th of January this year. Now let's have a look at the table config for the offline table. So we'll go over to our other tab, and we can see here we've got an hourly frequency. So that would kind of indicate from our formula that it's going to be 1 hour earlier than 6:41. So we would expect the time boundary to be 5:41. There is a way to check that. So we can call the broker's time boundary API, and this will return us, you can see it's an epoch time. So let's now pipe that into a little Python script to get a more human-friendly version. And you can see it comes back with 5:41 as we would expect. Now, ideally, we want that to be 6:41 so that in our queries, everything that's in the offline table uses the offline table, and everything after that is in the real-time table. And so there's actually a new time boundary API in Apache Pinot 0.12 that allows us to do just this. And so if we call that API, it'll come back and say, hey, I've updated the boundary. And we can then check again with the broker's time boundary API to check that it's been updated. And this time, yes, we're getting 6:41. So we would expect that we can now go back to the Pinot UI. And if we check how many records per segment, we can see we've now got 100,000 in that offline segment. So that's perfect. It's working exactly as we would want it to. And so that's the end of this video, in which we've learned how time boundaries work and how to adjust the time boundary when working with hybrid tables in Apache Pinot. Give it a try and let us know how you get on. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.